Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I want to show you how you can use Python Whisper, which is a general purpose speech recognition model, to basically convert your audio of your videos into text. This is extremely useful if you are like me, that you are not a native English speaker. And then unfortunately, YouTube doesn't work very well. So sometimes when I upload my videos, as you can see, an example here. This is convert a Word document to Markdown for free. This is a video that I've uploaded on YouTube. So if I click here and I'm in the subtitles section, you can see that YouTube has generated Italian subtitles for me automatically. This is very annoying because then when my users click on the subtitles, not only they don't get the right text, but also they get confused because, I mean, if anything, the subtitles shouldn't be there. And this, unfortunately, happens even if I tell YouTube that the language of my video is English. So if I go here, I click on details and I scroll down and I click on show more, I actually can show you that I selected that the language is English, but still YouTube has some issues and it is not working very well. And it recognized my voice is Italian because my background is Italian, and therefore it creates the subtitles in Italian, which is very annoying. So I always have to go here, I always have to check and then delete the subtitles. It would be fantastic then if there is a tool that we could use to quickly convert the speech to text, and it would be even better if it's actually accurate. And this is why I'm making this video, because this tool exists and is Whisper, and it works very well. I've already tested and I'm going to show it to you. I will show you how to install it on your computer and how to get started. And honestly, you only need 3 lines of code and you need Python installed on your computer. So let me show you how it works. So we pick a video here, which is prettier in Visual Studio Code. So how to format your code, your JavaScript code with prettier. And as you can see here, I've deleted the subtitles as I did before with the other video, and now we just have to add subtitles. So how can we do that? We just basically need to get the video on our computer, and then we need to run the Python Whisper package so it can convert the speech into text. So let me show you all the instructions to install it, and it's very well documented on their website. So it's on github.com/openai/whisper. So here the first thing that we need to do is we need to do pip install, and we can just copy this one here. And in order to do that, I'm using PyCharm. So here in PyCharm, I can go and click on file, and then I can say new project. And then here I can create a new project on my desktop, for instance, and then I can create a virtual environment. It's always a nice idea to compartmentalize your project, so I suggest you and I recommend you also to do that. So basically here you just have to click on create, this will create a new project, I've already created on my computer, so I don't need to do it again. And then inside the terminal, you can go here, and you can just run this command here, which is pip install, and then we are seeing this location of the code. Okay, so this is the first step that you need to do, is you need to do pip install. As you can see here, I have the virtual environment, here I have the bin, and then inside here I have a Whisper already installed. So that's the first step. The second step, as it's written on their website, is that based on your operative system, you also have to install FFmpeg if you don't have done it already. So in this case, I'm using Brew to install FFmpeg, and I'm installing it through the terminal, and I could have run the same command from PyCharm directly. As you can see, it took a bit of time, it downloaded a couple of things, a couple of files, but then eventually it was all done and everything was ready without any issues, okay? If you have some issues, as they say here, and you find some issue installing it during the pip install, you may also need to install Rust on your computer. So let me show you how it works, because it's very super simple actually. So here we have our project on desktop, and we have the main.py file, which contains the Python code, and then we have the file that we want to convert. So if you open the browser here, this is the same video as this one here, which is prettier Visual Studio Code. So the only thing that we need to do is to run this command here, which import Whisper, then it creates the model. And again, here, just have a look at their documentation, because it's very well written. They have several models. The smaller model have been trained with a smaller set of parameters, but then eventually they run much faster. And since my videos are actually in English, so that's why I'm just trying to convert speech to text in English, I'm using the English only model, so I'm using the small.en. It's pretty fast on my computer, and I'm using a Mac M1. So if you have you're using a computer even newer than mine, you can go also with the medium or even with the large model. So here we specify the model. The first time that you're going to run this command, as you can see here in my Python console, you can see that the first time that I run this command here, it took a bit of time to just download the model on my computer. And then eventually we just have to do result, which are equal to the model.transcribe, and here we have to specify the name of the video, which in this case is in the same directory as the Python file, so I don't have to crawl different directories, it's just in the same folder here. So here is the video. And then we can say print result.txt. So let me run the code again, I've already done it, but basically if I do Ctrl A, and then in my computer I created a shortcut to run this code, which in this case is Shift Option Theta, but it's not going to work in your case, most likely it's going to be Shift Option E. This is running the Whisper model, and then it's going to generate the text for us. And as you can see here, I've already the text generated for you, just to make sure that, to test that everything was working. So it's going to take a little bit of time. You can check here my watch at the top here, but you will see that it's pretty fast. In the meantime, while we wait, and I will fast forward later on the video, I would just like you to remind you to like the video if you can and subscribe to my channel if you found the content of this video useful and informative. If you want, you can also support the channel by buying me a coffee, more information down in the video description below, or supporting me on Patreon. This channel has no, as you can see, advertisement, so this is the only way that I can fund my channel. So as you can see, 1 minute or 30 seconds have passed, and I'm going to be fast forwarding this section here, and just keep an eye on the time when I will be back, and I will show you the results. Great, it is done. So it took less than 2 minutes, and here is the whole text. So we can just do triple click, control copy, and here I've just created a file where we can just put the text of the that we have just created, just because we just want to make sure that everything is okay. In this particular case, I can see that he did not recognize all the time that I was saying the word prettier. I'm not going to change it too much, this speech, but you can read it, of course, and that will be a nice idea. So I'm going to press on Ctrl-G, so I'm going to select all the instances here with a multi-cursor inside PyCharm, and then I'm going to change this to prettier. So now I've fixed at least prettier, the word prettier, because it's very important, because YouTube really reads the caption to better understand what is the content of the video. So it is very important that you upload your caption, and that's why I'm actually releasing this video. So now we can just press Ctrl A, Ctrl copy, we can go into our video here and we can add the subtitles. So I can click on add, and the very nice thing of YouTube is that there is auto sync. So I can press Ctrl V, here. This, as you can see, there are some errors that Grammarly is identifying, and we can actually click on them and Grammarly will be fixing it for us. But, so, basically it's done. Now we can just click on publish, and this is going to publish the video and it's going to generate the timing. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and thank you very much for watching. I'm looking forward to see you in the next video. Bye!